Hey everybody, it's Fedora. Welcome back to Disgaea 4. Last time we started episode 7 and fought our way through the three whatever the hells they were. Hopefully that won't be a recurring theme this episode, but we are going to continue on to the third battle. In this time for present with Busted Mythology. And this one right here is brutal. I just don't like the design. Disgaea does have these issues and I mentioned them. So we have a bunch of blues here with Lonely, and the greens are obscene. Quite the buffs, wouldn't you agree? And we have Turner Bogs, I am Error, haha, that are highly vulnerable to wind attacks. Now here's the thing, when you're in a Lonely, you can only have one unit in Lonely. They can be in the greens all they want, but you can only have one unit in the Lonely. So the stupid way to do this would be to do a suicide run with one person all the way through this Hall of Doom. What you can do, however, what I opt to do, get into the greens, and use your wind skills to beat them senseless. You could also do this from the blues too, and that's okay. If you can sink the enemy, that is. But anybody who has a wind attack will become extremely useful here. Here I come. But as you see, by doing something like this, now you can't move through the blues, so hoist by my own petard in demonstrating shit. My turn's over. I can't do it. I can't do none. To put it mildly, I deserve that. But you can't jump the walls, so that is something that can work to your advantage. But I'll have alternate things to do. He's still coming, by the way. I love the boss deal when he talks like that, because he does sound so sloshed, it's hilarious. I also like the boss deal because this is a really powerful attack. Probably a better way to do this more efficiently is to throw somebody. You can't throw from the blues though for the same stupid lonely reason. That's kind of why I don't like it at all, but it can be done. You just have to have the right cast. And Volcanus is also a good option. So, I think that'll work. The Wambulance! Oh god. And there's another kill. So you see, you do have quick ways to do it. Ow. I hit the SP damage thing. Annoying as hell, really. I think it's like half your HP. Now, what you can do is you can try to get to here, blow the thing up, and get yourself some spectacular bonuses in the process from all the Geopianos blowing up. Here's the thing. I've said before, in my process of leveling everybody up, that I've gone to the item world, and I've gotten rewards that are way better than this. This kind of just doesn't even have any relevancy anymore, incredibly, so I'll just use the opportunity to just do this, and we're done here. I said I'll just use the opportunity to do this, and we're done here. No kill, like overkill. Done. Yay. So, really, kind of inconsequential in that sense. So it plays a lot easier than it looks, which I could say about a lot of Disgaea levels. They play a lot easier than they look. It also helps when you have levels that are really high. And it. That's not an incorrect way to play Disgaea, because there is no real rules. Anyway.
It scared me.
There's no need to be scared of attacks that weren't meant to hit us.
I really like Valator's when he gets serious and actually shows how competent he is with things like this. Insights like that.
A warning shot to show off their power. That's to be
expected from beasts trying to defend. When he's not being a gigantic idiot, which is every other time.
Desko didn't know that one attack would have so much meaning behind it. Desko will try it out when she becomes the final boss.
Unfortunately, every time Valvatoris gets serious about something and seems really cool, he has five other characters who just go ahead and destroy that seriousness with their own stupidity.
Don't think too highly of yourselves just because you beat those three goons.
So we beat the three goons in the last part, and now we're going to beat the four whatchamacallits here.
They're nothing but sludges compared to us. It's embarrassing. Tyrant Valvatoris, huh? You're just a relic of the past.
If you had only stayed in your nest at the bottom of Hades, you wouldn't have had to die here. You're such a
They're the four devas of the Netherworld.
The four devas.
The vile demons who guard the four gates of the Netherworld.
So we went from the three Baba Ganushas now to the four devas. What's next?
Garatea of the East, Arceus of the West, Gracius of the South, and Repicon of the North. The four of them together are strong enough to annihilate the entire world.
Oh. Well, that's great.
Just like the three before were the source of all fear. Yes.
But these guys are even stronger. Countless humans have spent sleepless nights because
So they're the cause of insomnia. Nice.
So, that means I pretty much have the upper hand since I'm already asleep.
Or delusional.
So we can win by sleeping? Desko will fall asleep now too.
Remember what I said about Valvatoris being serious? Somebody has to bring down the moon and go to the silly place. Desko's gonna do it this time.
No, that's wrong! And how can you fall asleep so quickly anyway?
Hello? Please wake up, Miss Desko. You're gonna get killed.
Just leave these kids here. At least we won't have to take care of them anymore.
Aw, are you being a tsundere again?
Killing.
That's a yes.
Not your enemies, Fenrir. Take your anger out on the Corruptimen instead.
Miss Desko! Miss Desko! Please wake up! The battle is starting! Is it time for breakfast already?
Do final bosses regularly fall asleep at the drop of a hat? I never knew this. Anyway. Now we went from the three Baba Ganushas now to the four, whatever the fucks they are. As you see, they have their own little things here, but first we gotta get rid of the no entry. Evade, enemy boost 50%, magic range 1, and the enemy boost is right here just to really fuck with you. So, I'm not too worried. Once again, the Chernobogs are extremely weak to wind, and really, Garatea is also extremely weak to wind. It's almost as if the game said, hey, keep doing what you were doing. I also have other ways to cause massive damage, but I'll just opt for a little bit of that. Now, to inflict massive damage, Amiezel, Fenric, and Celis are all very good options for me. So, let's start. One. Volcanus also can fill in a pinch. But these three should be able to get the job done.
Here I come.
I might have to lift him, though. So, who wants to do some lifting? You. You can lift.
Your back is wide open.
I do like the fact that Fenrir can just streak pretty much anywhere with his speed. And not quite. I'll need someone else. I'd rather use Valvatoris for something more constructive, because his firepower is too outstanding to ignore.
God, bless me. This is it!
Yeah, Fuga, you'll do the job just fine. There we go. Now,
everyone, let's go.
Valvatoris. we could start taking on these guys. Did that say Jesse James? I'm easily distracted. No, it didn't. I was hallucinating or something.
Disappear. I'll show you.
Good start. Another kill. A counter. Counter back. And that's three down. So, now we get to move on. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to deal with some 50%ers, but in the red area, but that's fine. Or they ignored it. That's actually rather curious. And counters aplenty. Ooh, nice. Lucina got one. What I also like about when they do this is when they end up collapsing on you, they leave a lot of those formations that are very, very vulnerable to a certain type of attack, and the ones that have the range that's radial, it's perfect for them. Maybe Glorious Sitter. Oh, that would take a Measle out. Unfortunate. That's better. Glorious Hitter. Good. Rain Blast. There we go. Good. Good. And he even stuck the 29 for good measure. That's what I like to see. Now it's time to push forward. And we're going to graduate into a new area this time. Attack plus 50%. With Valvatorus, this is kind of unfair. The first. You're down. In truth, I think evade is probably the most annoying because it's evade by definition. It's annoying. But I can't imagine anybody else having issues. I forgot you were there. Whoops. Oh well. That should help. And now we can push forward. So, next turn. This one right here is actually, this stage I find to be pretty simple as well. Like I said, there's definitely a handful of examples. I'm just going to draw these Chernobogs fire, and I'll probably try to wipe them out with someone. Maybe a Fenric. Fenric, because he's got the wind attacks. Well, why not? Let's do a Soul Reaper. We never use these. Everybody else this way. I do want to actually clog this up so they can't use the 50%, so that is going to be part of the plan, hopefully. Anyway, down he goes. Not bad, two of the four done. There's the churn box like I predicted. And this is actually gonna go almost exactly like I thought. They collapse down, and they leave themselves quite a very cluttered formation, but I'm just gonna use the opportunity to take Desko and just do this instead. And do massive damage to Arceus at the top. As a result. Nice. God, I love the boss heal so much. So useful. I know I've said that numerous times, but it really just bears repeating for me. I just enjoy using it so much. Anyway, the churn bugs need to go bye-bye soon, so... Here, let's make it happen. One down. And this ninja right here is weak to ice. That's good to know. Alternately, though, if you don't want to deal with their bullshit, there's no law that says you can't do this. Here, buddy, I'll help you. I might lose a measle here, but I don't really care. Everybody's collapsing down that way, and they're going to go after Disgaea, which is a pretty, bad idea. Matter of fact, with this formation, I can definitely cause untold damage. So you could do that. Can I do a cross demon rush? Yes, I can. I don't have enough distance. Crap. Well, I can always make distance. Bloody Hole, which I absolutely love using. And you can still get some pretty good level ups by doing this, so that's also awesome. Too bad I can't finish the job right now. I have an idea.
Here I come.
That wasn't the idea. This is the idea. Special burst, special kill.
I'm still coming.
Yep, I remember that attack. Also, those guys just done fuck up by taking on my two best counterattacking machines. One, I guess. And, yeah, Fuka, you can dust this guy off. There you go, done. Anakin, appoint environmental minister. Yay, because nothing screams hell quite like the regulation of sulfur.
We beat the three brutes and the four demons!
Yes, we beat three Baba Ganooshes and four more Baba Ganooshes. What's next? The five Baba Ganooshes? I wonder if that's a nod to the fact there's a lot of untold things, enemies and stuff that woke up after like 1,000 years or 10,000 years of sleep and are now all powerful. Or were sealed away.
I'm not interested in teaching tricks to monkeys. My duty is to help our Lord with his missions, not to train primates.
Monkeys? That's a little harsh, don't you think, Mr. Werewolf?
She's right, Fenric. Teach them tricks as a pretty instructor.
He's got you there, Fenric. Don't think of them as prince. Think of them as pretties, dude.
We're almost up to the final battle.
After all is for my lord. So, not bad. Let's continue onward. To the post-purge purge. The post-purge purge. Oof. What's a post-purge anyway? Besides a mouthful. Post-purge purge.
Sir Fenric, dude! We're here to report in!
Great. How goes the battle?
Our demon supporters are showing more strength than expected, and the classes are joining forces to fight in each area, dude! But they won't be able to fight like that for much longer. The longer the battle goes, the more disadvantage we have, dude!
We don't have time to waste then. Let's hurry!
There's no need. This is as far as you will go.
Who dat? Oh boy, it's you guys. Wait, Prinny?
Another one? What now?
They are the seven Yakshas of the Netherworld. They possess the power to return the world to nothingness in just 7 days.
Wow, so we've graduated from 5 and 6 all the way to 7. So we go from 3 Bob Ganoushes to 4, what to McCall's to 7, doesn't matter who you are. We're definitely making progress, albeit I don't know what progress we're making.
There are 7 this time? The groups are getting bigger and bigger.
They are.
Alright, we're not going to introduce each one of their members anymore, agree?
Do you guys see that familiar face among them too?
Yes, I see a pretty dude. You're not a Prinny, you say.
If I look like a Prinny to you, that means you still need more training.
Says the one who reaches into his, fanny pack and pulls out a skull like all Prinnies do.
Is that right? Well, then I apologize.
But there is one good way to test whether or not something is a Prinny.
What is it that you want? How much?
Pardon me?
The entire Netherworld has descended into chaos because of your trifling rebellion. The President doesn't wish for the situation to continue any longer.
So you're trying to buy us out?
Do you really think you can bribe me just like that?
Yes.
Is money not enough? We can also offer the title of the 4 Devas or the 3 Brutes if you desire status.
I'm interested in those lame-ass titles. I'll create my own in that case. I agree. I don't know if I like the idea of these 3 Bob Ganoushes, the 4 Whatchamacallits, and the 7 Shits.
I'm not interested in a position within a rotten organization. My mission is to restore the Netherworld to its former glory.
Make hell burn again.
Absurd? You are hardly one to talk. Learn your place, Prinny Instructor, rotten organization. You have no idea how much the President is concerned about the Netherworld.
Father? He's concerned?
Father, who do you think you are? Sir Amizel has already passed away.
No, I didn't. I'm still alive. I'm still here.
Didn't 3... whatever, acknowledge his existence?
Then why must you interfere with the President? Why must you bring catastrophe to the Netherworld?
Interfere? That's not what I was...
Dead or alive, you should have stayed in Hades. What is it that you're trying to accomplish by joining the rebels? Have you given in to their threats? Or are you trying to get revenge against the President for abandoning you?
No, that's not... I just wanted to...
Hey, you! I don't know who you are with that fancy title above your head, and I don't care, but don't you dare speak like that to a kid! What's so wrong about a kid just wanting to see his dad? Worked really hard up until now to make his dad proud. Is that so wrong? He had to become a rebel because you corrupt and bastards officially made him dead with that fake news. Luca.
Nicely said, Lance. First you try to bribe us, then you put your cowardice on a pedestal while chastising a child. Why is it so hard to believe that rebels like us would stand up to fight against you rotten souls? No matter how concerned the President is, the fact of the matter is the universe is malfunctioning. There's no excuse for that. Corruptment that can't fulfill its responsibilities or keep its promises to the citizens must be overthrown immediately.
Hear, hear.
So, you still insist on rebelling. And all of you are with him, I assume.
I'm only here to collect the money you owe. I have no intention of being bargained with or selling my soul.
Desco only wants to become a final boss. She's not interested in cheap titles like the 3 Brutes or 4 Days.
True. A final boss must stand on her own. As a final boss.
Oh, my lord.
And that concludes our negotiations. You have no choice but to die!
And so with that, now we are going to take on the Seven Shits. So, they're scattered around. There's also a bunch of bombs here, which means you get warning, don't throw. You know exactly what that means. And there's a bunch of random-ass prinis here, too. But we're greeted by the first of the Seven Yakshas. He is not a prini, but we could test that theory, and I shall test it right now. Let's test it. Oh, he was a prini after all. And there you go. What I don't like about this camera is every time these explosions happen, it seems to zoom in on its own. I don't like that at all.
Here I come.
But with that out of the way,
yeah.
We can now move forward. Nah, target height problem. Oh well.
Here I go.
Yeah. And of course, these guys are still annoyingly fast, which is going to cause pain and suffering of its own.
God, bless me.
Come on.
God, bless me.
There you go.
Annihilation!
I love it. The Basil, such an idiot. Let's see if we can... Oh yeah! That's what I like to see. Let's go bring out Izzy too. He can help matters. And also send this guy up forward. All those prinis, by the way, the random ones are like level 20. You should be able to walk right through them. Now just simply going to crawl up the stairs. The Yakshas will come down and fight you at some point. As you get close, so. The guy I just saw right there. Oh yeah, the extinction laser is really powerful. Especially when they don't move. Oof. It's a beautiful thing. Alright, time for another attack from the captain. That's unfair. Not a fair fight when you have extinction laser like that. And a really good attack. On top of the 50% of not moving. You didn't kill a level 20 prinny. I'm very disappointed in you, Volcanus. Never send an angel to do a demon's job. And the game crashed. Fuck. Thanks to the jackass of a game deciding to crash on me, because apparently it hated the fact that I was flexing on its ass with Captain Morgan. That's just me. I'm going to flex it a little harder, because that's just the way I am. Let's go. Yeah, your prinis aren't going to do anything. Why do you bother trying? Well, at least you brought two of the Yakshas out. And all the counters you can want. Okay. Now since they're here. I also have a new attack, Tyrant Flukeud. Quite the distance, wouldn't you agree? But I'll just do this instead. One prey decides, I'm going to attack Valvatorus like an idiot. Alright, buddy. Let's go. You guys can do that, and we'll send you over this way. Yeah. And right here, into this ammo dump. There you go. And see, just like that, we're almost done. There goes your armor, and there goes your life. That should do it. There you go. Just like that, we're done. No big deal. So now the seven shits are done.
They weren't half bad, considering their extreme sounding titles. I love my dream. I can sense a happy ending is just around.
Yeah, if those are war demons, then I'll pass.
Strange. The members of the seven yakshas couldn't possibly be that weak. Three brutes. Devas and seven yakshas. Must be something behind all this.
Maybe that's why they tried to buy us out.
Was that another of Father's orders? But they said Father's concerned about the Netherworld.
All of this will be made clear when you get to ask him in person. There's no point in raising those questions now.
You're right. I'm not running away anymore.
That's the spirit, rascal.
Fixes, do you wish to see your daddy too?
What now? I don't want to see him at all. Who cares about some stupid dad who doesn't even come home for his daughter's birthday? He left me all alone every day, just so he could focus on his research. Seriously, damn you, old man. Well, on to the Netherworld President's office. Let's go, Disgaea.
As touching as that is for Fuka, let's be honest, there is a reason she's a prinny. Or was destined to be a prinny. So it's hard to take anything she says at face value. I'm pretty sure she's a compulsive liar. To some degree. Anyway. Before the game decided prematurely on my part, I'm gonna end it officially. By healing. So. We have three more battles to go here, actually, so. There's definitely action to go. I see Valvatores is getting some ridiculous levels now. He's so powerful right now. This is a product of the fact his abilities are just that freaking good. I'm not trying to give him more attention. It's just, it's so convenient to use something that's basically a walking nuke. Which is why everyone else barely has even done anything. So, that's it for this part. Next time, probably going to do the next two battles. I want to put the last one on its own part, because you know how the plot dumps are at the end of each Disgaea episode. / start to the next. And being a final episode, you know there's going to be a lot. So, see you guys next time. 40 Wars signing off.